It is my proud privilege and honor to welcome Honorable President of India and the eminent gathering on the occasion of 8th Public Sector Day celebrations and presentation of Scope Excellence Awards and Scope Meritorious Awards being organized by Scope and DPE. On behalf of the entire public sector fraternity, I express our gratitude to Honorable President of India for kindly gracing the occasion and present the awards. Sir, your kind words of wisdom have always been a great source of inspiration in our efforts to ensure consistent improvement in the performance of PSEs. Thank you very much, sir. I also extend a hearty welcome to Honorable Minister for Heavy Industries and Public Enterprises, Shri Anant Ji Gite, and Shri Babul Supriyo, Honorable Minister of State for Heavy Industries and Public Enterprises, for their guidance and providing desired direction to PSEs in their march forward for the cause of nation building. I also welcome Secretary DP and each one of you, and also the members of media fraternity for being present in large numbers here. Honorable Rashtrapati Ji, as you are aware that public sector has been playing a crucial role in economic and social advancement of our country, a task entrusted to us since inception. Public enterprises have achieved a fair measure of success in developing industrial infrastructure, promoting regional balances, and creating employment opportunities. It gives me immense pleasure to share that while the recent demonetization drive was one of the major reforms to combat corruption, the public sector enterprises have excelled in best practices of corporate governance and are working towards creating a digital infrastructure for promoting cashless economy. So, the Public Sector Day celebrates the spirit and cause of the public sector, and at the same time, we reiterate our commitment to take India on the path of economic prosperity and human development. Scope Awards acknowledge the continuous efforts of PSEs to achieve corporate excellence and also encourage others to make more efforts to attain competitive advantage. With these words, I welcome our Honorable President, Sir Shri Pranab Mukherjee, and other dignitaries. Once again, Jai Hind.
It is a matter of great privilege and honor for all of us to have the Honorable President of India in our midst today on the occasion of the 8th Public Sector Day celebrations and presentation of Scope Excellence and Meritorious Awards. Public Sector Day recognizes the enormous contribution made by our central public sector enterprises to the socio-economic development of our country, and it provides a platform to formulate a futuristic vision and promote innovation and competitiveness in the CPSEs. Public sector enterprises have been the backbone of the Indian economy, contributing in a wide range of sectors, ranging from defense to steel, mines, oil, heavy industry, just to name a few. The government has a very high expectation from them in setting standards of excellence in the fields of management, corporate governance, and corporate social responsibility. Sir, the Department of Public Enterprises is the nodal department for public sector. It is our endeavor to continuously take initiatives to improve the performance of CPSEs by creating an enabling work environment through a supportive policy framework. I would like to mention some of the initiatives taken by the department. The role of the board has undergone a sea change in recent years in order to bring in objectivity, transparency, and accountability to the functioning of the board. The government is appointing professionals as non-official directors. The Department of Public Enterprises plays a crucial role in the capacity building and sensitization of these non-official directors. Through the instrumentality of the MOU, the Department of Public Sector Enterprises and the administrative ministries incentivize and motivate the CPSEs to achieve overall business excellence. This is done keeping in mind the priorities of the government, such as incentivizing the micro and small enterprises, increasing the capital expenditure by CPSEs, etc. I am glad to inform you, sir, that the public enterprises have taken a lead in promoting digitization in line with the vision of the government. So far, CPSEs have provided trainings to approximately 6.27 lakh employees, contractual workers, consumers, merchants, and other similar target groups in various modes of digital transactions. They have also been giving incentives to customers and consumers by waiving the transaction fees, MDR charges, to promote cashless transactions. We are extremely grateful to our Honorable President for gracing this occasion. When we recognize the outstanding performance of our public sector enterprises, I would like to compliment all the award winners on their excellent performance and hope that CPSEs continue to achieve greater heights in the years to come. Thank you.
I would like to congratulate Scope at the outset for making this possible, where all the leaders from our very important public sector enterprises from CPSEs have all gathered together and are not only going to be winning their own awards in the presence of none other than the Honorable President of India, but also to get inspired by the achievements and the performances of their colleagues in their own companies as well as their competitive companies. It's a matter of great honor, and it goes beyond saying that it is a privilege for all of us to have Honorable President amongst us on the occasion of this Public Sector Day and presentation of Scope Awards. Honorable President, as always, my heartiest gratitude to you, our heartiest gratitude to you for making this day very, very special for all of us. Thank you, sir. Seema ji, our secretary, had very aptly put the importance of public sector enterprises, the CPSEs, in our society, in our economy, and the socio-economic role that all of you play in our country. And all of you are, in fact, leaders and stalwarts and great professionals from that field. So I need not tell you what exactly is the job that all of you are doing, or what exactly is the definition of CPSEs and in terms of the job, in terms of the work that all of you are doing for the country and for the society. I am sure all of you know it much better than us, or rather me, because I am a minister in this department only for the last, how many, maybe 6 months, six, 7 months. So first of all, thank you so much for all of you being here. However, I would like to throw a little bit of light on the mathematics of the CPSEs as they perform, in terms of their performance and how important an economic role they play in our country in terms of volume. Honorable President, sir, the public sector has performed exceptionally well since its inception after independence. I must remind you, though, exceptional is a very relative term. I'll come to that a little later. The central public sector enterprises, or the CPSEs, in the country started with 5 units in 1951, and since then the number of CPSEs has grown to 320 at present, of which 244 are operating at the present point of time. The investment in CPSEs has also increased from rupees 29 crores in 1951, just rupees 29 crore in 1951, to over rupees 1,171,000 crore. I really will have to go back and count the zeros in that, in 2015-16. During the same year, the capital employed of central public sector enterprises was about rupees 19,38,000 crore, which was more than 5% over the five previous year, and the CPSEs earned overall profit of about rupees 1,15,000 crore during the year 2015-16, which was around 12% more than the previous year. The CPSEs contributed around rupees 2,78,000 crore to central exchequer, which was more than 38% of the previous year. I must tell you that the total number of zeros in this figure is definitely much more than the number of zeros that I may have dealt in my mathematics exams in my entire school, college, and my graduation day. So I think you can clap for all of yourselves today. Yeah, that's you clapping for yourself in the presence of our Honorable President. However, in today's dog-eat-dog world and in the scenario of global competition, not only in terms of quality, but also in terms of quantity, as I said, exceptional is a word that is very, very relative, and it is up to you and all of us to set the bar, raise the bar, and so that, you know, people in the country can not only once, but say it bar bar that you guys are doing very well, and we are all doing very well. So I am glad. It's important to keep the speech short because we are all looking forward to what the president, who in his illustrious career in different roles, have actually thrown light and enlightened all of us with his knowledge and inspirational words. We would all look forward to what he has to say to all of us today. So at the end, I would just thank SCOPE as the apex public sector organization for taking this proactive and progressive step in areas such as human resource management, corporate governance, and women empowerment, and everything that the government, the central government, under the able leadership of Honorable Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi ji, is trying to achieve in the country. I wish once again all of you all the very best. I'm sure the award winners are going to rejoice as much as their colleagues, who are also going to rejoice and inspire themselves with the great performances that has been put in by their colleagues. Once again, thank you so much, Mahamahim President Sir, for making this day very special for all of us. Thank you. Namaskar.
सबसे पहले मैं राष्ट्रपति जी का धन्यवाद करूंगा। उन्हें इस पुरस्कार वितरण समारोह में आज वे यहाँ पर उपस्थित है और इसीलिए मैं मेरे मंत्रालय की ओर से, स्कोप की ओर से, सबसे पहले राष्ट्रपति जी प्रणब मुखर्जी जी का धन्यवाद करता हूँ। वैसे मेरे लिए ये दूसरा अवसर है, पिछली बार भी ये अवसर मुझे प्राप्त हुआ था। दोबारा इस पुरस्कार वितरण समारोह में मंत्री के नाते मैं यहाँ पर उपस्थित हूँ। मेरे पूर्व वक्ताओं ने जो बातें यहाँ पर कही है, मैं उसे यहाँ पर दोहराना नहीं चाहूँगा, लेकिन राष्ट्र के आज़ादी के साथ साथ राष्ट्र के निर्माण में हमारे लोक उद्यम विभाग ने, सार्वजनिक उपक्रम विभाग ने अपनी अहम भूमिकाएं निभाई हैं। पिछले कुछ वर्षों से इन सार्वजनिक उद्यमों को कई कठिनाइयों का सामना करना पड़ रहा है, इसलिए कि ये वैश्वीकरण का जमाना है और वैश्वीकरण का जमाना होने के कारण प्रतिस्पर्धा विश्व स्तर तक पहुंची है और इस प्रतिस्पर्धा में हमारे सार्वजनिक उद्यमों को सबसे कड़ा मुकाबला यदि किसी से करना पड़ रहा है तो चाइना से करना पड़ रहा है। विशेषकर मैन्युफैक्चरिंग सेक्टर में आज पूरे विश्व भर चाइना छा गया है और ऐसी स्थिति में हमारे सारे लोक उद्यम इस प्रतिस्पर्धा में टिके हैं और केवल टिके ही नहीं, तो इस प्रतिस्पर्धा में पूरे विश्व के साथ सफलतापूर्वक हमारे सारे सीपीएसयू इस प्रतिस्पर्धा में सफल हो रहे हैं और इसीलिए जिन सीपीएसयू को इस पुरस्कार के लिए चुना गया है, मैं उन सारे सीपीएसयू का, उन पुरस्कार विजेताओं का हृदयपूर्वक अभिनंदन करता हूँ और अभिनंदन करते हुए आने वाला जो हमारा कल है, इस कल के लिए इन सारे उद्यमों को मैं शुभकामना देता हूँ। मैं धन्यवाद दूंगा हमारे लोक उद्यम विभाग को, श्रीमती सीमा बहुगुणा जी, जिन्होंने अभी इस विभाग कुछ माह पहले ही उन्होंने इस विभाग को संभाला है, लेकिन लोक उद्यम विभाग हो, स्कोप हो, हम मिलकर अपनी सार्वजनिक जो हमारे उपक्रम है, उद्योग है, लोक उद्यम है, उनको बनाए रखने का, उनको आगे बढ़ाने का प्रयास कर रहे हैं। मैं धन्यवाद दूंगा प्रधानमंत्री नरेंद्र मोदी जी को भी। एक चुनौती के तौर पर जो लोक उद्यम हमारे सफलता की ओर आगे बढ़ रहे हैं उनको तो हम सहयोग कर ही रहे हैं, लेकिन जो लोक उद्यम संकट में है और जो संकट से बाहर आने की संभावना है, ऐसे लोक उद्यमों को संकट से बाहर निकालने का भी प्रयास हम कर रहे हैं। और जहाँ तक कुछ लोक उद्यम ऐसे हैं जो इस संकट से बाहर आ ही नहीं सकते, तो थोड़ा सा कड़वा यह निर्णय होगा, लेकिन उस निर्णय को हम इसलिए ले रहे हैं कि जो जनता का धन है वो जनता के विकास में काम आए, विकास के लिए काम आए, और जिस उद्यमों को हम चला नहीं पाते हैं उनको बंद करने का भी निर्णय हम कर रहे हैं। मैं यह जानकारी राष्ट्रपति जी को यहाँ पर देना चाहता हूँ, और इसीलिए इस प्रतिस्पर्धा में हमारे सारे लोक उद्यम हैं जिन्होंने इस प्रतिस्पर्धा में जो पुरस्कार पाया है, उन सारे पुरस्कार विजेताओं का फिर एक बार अभिनंदन करता हूँ, और सरकार की ओर से, विभाग की ओर से, मंत्रालय की ओर से ये विश्वास दिलाता हूँ कि हमारा लोक उद्यम सार्वजनिक उपक्रम विभाग, सरकार आपके साथ है। बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद।
We begin the award presentation ceremony with the institutional category. Rural Electrification Corporation Limited has the privilege, ladies and gentlemen, to receive two awards from the Honorable President of India. These are Scope Excellence Award Institutional Category 1, Maharatna Navratna PSE, and Scope Meritorious Awards in the field of Best Managed Bank, Financial Institution or Insurance Company. I now request Dr. P.V. Ramesh, IAS Chairman and Managing Director of REC, to receive the gold trophy of the two awards, please. National Aluminium Company Limited, I now request Dr. T.K. Chand, Chairman and Managing Director of NALCO, to receive two awards, Scope Excellence Awards Institution Category 1, Maharatna Navratna, and Scope Meritorious Awards for Corporate Social Responsibility and Responsiveness. Please keep the applause going, ladies and gentlemen. Engineers India Limited, I now request Mr. Sanjay Gupta, Chairman and Managing Director, Engineers India Limited, to receive the Special Commendation Award of Scope Excellence Awards in the Institution Category 1, Maharatna Navratna. Mineral Exploration Corporation, I now request Dr. Gopal Dhawan, Chairman and Managing Director, Mineral Exploration Corporation, to receive the Gold Trophy Scope Excellence Award in the Institutional Category 2, Mini Ratna 1 and 2. ONGC Videsh Limited, I now request Mr. D.K. Saraf, Chairman OVL and Chairman and Managing Director, ONGC, and Mr. N.K. Verma, Managing Director, ONGC Videsh Limited, to receive the Gold Trophy of Institutional Category 2, Mini Ratna 1 and 2 PSEs. WAPCOS Limited, I now call upon Mr. R.K. Gupta, Chairman and Managing Director of WAPCOS Limited, to receive two awards, the Special Commendation Award in the Institutional Category 2, Mini Ratna 1 and 2 PSE, and Scope Meritorious Awards for Corporate Governance. Electronics Corporation of India, I now request Mr. Debashish Das, Chairman and Managing Director, Electronics Corporation of India, to receive a Gold Trophy of Scope Excellence Awards in the Institutional Category 3. Goa Shipyard Limited, I now request Admiral Shekhar Mittal, Nauseva Medal, Indian Navy, retired, Chairman and Managing Director of Goa Shipyard Limited, to receive the Gold Trophy in the Special Institutional Category of Scope Excellence Awards. The individual category awards, ladies and gentlemen, now we have the pleasure to announce the individual leadership category award, which are given to encourage and recognize outstanding persons for their dedicated leadership attributes. We have pleasure in announcing two outstanding awards to two stalwarts of PSUs, a plaque and a check of rupees 1 lakh each. NBCC, I call upon Dr. Anup Kumar Mittal, Chairman and Managing Director, NBCC, to receive the trophy in recognition of his contribution. And I now call upon Mr. B. Ashok, Chairman of Maharatna India Oil Corporation, to receive the plaque for his outstanding leadership. And he gets a special commendation for him today from the Honorable President of India in recognition of his outstanding contribution to the overall growth of the company in the individual leadership category, One Maharatna and Navratna. Rajasthan Electronics and Instruments Limited, I now call upon Mr. A.K. Jain, Managing Director, Rajasthan Electronics and Instruments Limited, to receive two awards, a plaque, of course a check in the individual leadership category, two Mini Ratna 1 and 2 PSC, Scope Meritorious Award for R&D, Technology Development and Innovation. Indian Renewable Energy Development Agency Limited, I call upon Mr. K.S. Popley, Chairman and Managing Director of Indian Renewable Energy Development Agency Limited, to receive the plaque and a check in the individual leadership category 3. I now call upon Ms. Pooja Kapoor, Head Business Development, WAPCOS, to receive the gold trophy in the field of outstanding women managers in PSEs. I now call upon Ms. Seema Gupta, Executive Director, Power Grid Corporation, to receive the Special Commendation Award in the category of Outstanding Woman Manager in PSEs. NTPC Limited, I now call upon Mr. Gurdeep Singh, Chairman and Managing Director of NTPC Limited, to receive the Gold Trophy from the Honorable President of India in the field of Scope Meritorious Awards in the field of RTI Act 2005 compliance. Steel Authority of India, I now call upon Mr. P.K. Singh, Chairman of Steel Authority of India Limited, to receive the Gold Trophy of Scope Meritorious Award for the best practices in human resource management. Now I call upon Dr. Ashutosh Karnatak, Director of Projects, Gail India Limited, to receive the Gold Trophy of Scope Meritorious Award for RTI Act 2005 compliance. Hindustan Petroleum Corporation Limited, I call upon Mr. M.K. Surana, Chairman and Managing Director, Hindustan Petroleum Corporation Limited, to receive two awards from the Honorable President in the field of Environmental Excellence and Sustainable Development and Scope Meritorious Award for the Best Women Empowered Company. Power Finance Corporation Limited, I now request Mr. Rajiv Sharma, Chairman and Managing Director of Power Finance Corporation Limited, to receive the Gold Trophy of Scope Meritorious Award for Good Corporate Governance from the Honorable President of India. Hindustan Aeronautics Limited, I now request Mr. T. Suvarna Raju, Chairman and Managing Director of Hindustan Aeronautics Limited, to receive the Gold Trophy of Scope Meritorious Award for Good Corporate Governance from the Honorable President of India. Thank you very much, Honorable President of India.
I would like to congratulate the awardees for their performance of the year under review. They have been considered by a very distinguished jury as the excellent performance for the year under review in the public sector enterprises. Public sector enterprises in our country
has a very long story. And the story is not always a tale of success. There had been ups and downs. There had been questions. And even the very basic principle on which at the beginning of our planning in the early 50s, immediate after our independence, when public sector enterprise was chosen as the vehicle of industrialization of this country, there are many critics. Some of them may be justified, but when we look back from our days of planned economic development and thereafter make an assessment, I think we'll feel happy at the performance of public sector enterprises. They were not only the starter, they began. Hardly there was any capital. Hardly there was any investable surplus available to our public sector, private sectors. Therefore, like many other countries who were neo-liberated from long spell of colonial rules, had to depend on the state for supply of capital, technology, and create the environment for appropriate industrialization. From a very small beginning, if I remember correctly, at the beginning, there were only 5 public sector enterprises with an investment of rupees 29 crores. Of course, our first 5-year plan itself was around 1,500 crores of investment. And when we compare today, the figures are truly mind-boggling, as in the year 2015-16, central public sector enterprises turnover was 18,54,687 crores. Currently, out of 320 central public sector enterprises, 244 are operating, and their net profit after paying dividend taxes are around 12.5%. It is truly appreciable because the industrial climate all over the world is not very encouraging. There is no doubt at some point of time that some aberrations were noticed and the corrections were made immediately in course of time. That is the beauty of our system, that we have adequate elbow room and a flexible approach towards our economic development. We have not followed any particular dogma, or we did not mortgage our process even in the days of height of public sector enterprises, as it was described, by enjoying the commanding height, scope of private sectors, particularly in the small and medium industries, was so vast that it contributed substantially to our process of industrialization and the overall economic development. Because we have the flexible policies, and we did not hesitate to make change. If I remember correctly, the first industrial policy was adopted by independent India in 1948. Thereafter, major changes were brought in 1956, 1973, 1980, and finally 1991, which is considered as the beginning of the era of liberalization. Whole range of changes were brought in, as a result of which Indian economy unleashed its potentiality, and today it is emerging as first among the emerging economies. Days are not far off when Indian economy will be considered, I am not merely talking from purchasing power parity, it is already we are third, but even in terms of value, absolute terms, Indian economy will be in the first 3, 4, 5 countries, perhaps within the next decade. It is reachable. And the industrial unrest, economic problems, which are going on from 2008 onwards, which was considered as one of the worst economic financial crises in the world after the Great Depression of 1931, India came out. And thanks to the substantial contribution of Indian public sector banks, when all other mighty banking systems collapsed with a small indiscretion of a housing mortgaging bank, the giants started tottering, but Indian banking system remained as steadfast, as steady as possible. Even during the Eurozone crisis, we had many problems. At least a substantial part of this period, I happened to be the minister, and I had the opportunity of examining the problems from inside, in national perspective, in international perspective. Therefore, I always believe strongly that Indian public sector story has not closed. It is unfolding stories, and many more glorious chapters will be added to its credit in the years to come. Of course, somebody may brush aside my opinion that I am the product of that regime which strongly believed in the public sector culture. At the same time, I am also the product, because my ministerial career of 25 years are almost equally divided in the pre-liberated and in the post-liberated era. Therefore, perhaps that type of brushing would not be appropriate, I do believe. And that's why it is not for the first time. If I remember correctly, umpteen number of times I have associated myself with the various functions of scope, and even in the award-giving functions, as Mr. Gite was saying, during his regime, I was also there. Earlier, during Praful Patel's regime, I was also there. Therefore, because of my attachment to the public sector enterprises and public sector culture belief, because I always believed that there were excellent performers in public sectors. It's not a question of branding public or private. It's a question of excellency. It's a question of efficiency. It's a question of commitment. It's a question of showing results. And we have seen that in both sectors, India have produced excellent, large number of efficient managers. Therefore, I congratulate all the award winners, and I do hope the examples which you have set in your performance, you are not operating from a different planet. You are operating from the same atmosphere, same ambient, same country. So natural question would be, if you can do well, why not others? And to draw to this attention, I do feel this award-giving ceremony has its significance. It encourages the people to have better performance. If X can do, yes, I can do. And this moment this spirit comes, country will advance. Nothing can prevent that. I thank you, Mr. Ved Prakash, for inviting me and the minister to participate in this function. I congratulate all the award winners, wish them Godspeed and further success. There is no limit. Sky is the limit. Reach the sky. Have wings. Fix it and fly. Country will be with you. Carry the country to its desired post and achieve what country expects out of you. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Jai Hind.